In this lesson, I'm going to launch an application load balancer, enable access logging so we're recording information about the requests being made to the load balancer, and then we're going to use Amazon Athena to run SQL queries against that data, which will be located in an Amazon S3 bucket. Back in the console, I'm going to head over to AWS CloudFormation, and we're going to use CloudFormation to build out a stack that creates the load balancer. I'm going to use the very same template I've used in other labs earlier. I'm going to pop into the Elastic Load Balancing directory in the course download and choose this option, ALBCF template. Click on Upload, click on Next, provide a stack name, ALB Access Logs Lab, and then provide an image ID. So again, I'm going to head over to EC2, click on Launch Instance, copy the AMI ID of the Amazon Linux instance here, and then paste that into image ID. Then I'm going to select the default VPC and two subnets in the default VPC. Click on Next, Next again, and then Submit. And that's going to create the stack for our load balancer. Next, I'm going to open up Amazon S3, and let's create an S3 bucket for this particular exercise. So I'll call this access-logs-alb, and then let's make it nice and unique. I don't need to make any changes here. I'm just going to create the bucket. So the bucket has been created. I'll select the bucket. We'll go over to permissions, and we do need to edit the bucket policy here. In the course download in the Amazon Athena directory, you'll find this file, querying application load balancer logs. Here is the policy that we need for our S3 bucket. Now note that there's a principle here, and it has an account number. You don't want to change this. This is actually an AWS account number. Leave that as it is. This is providing access to the load balancer service, and it's going to allow put object, but we do need to change the bucket ARN here. So let's copy all of this JSON, and back in the policy editor for the bucket policy, I'm going to paste this in. Copy my bucket ARN and then paste it in here, making sure that I keep the /AWS logs /* on the end. And then save those changes. And that is my bucket setup. Let's come back to EC2, and I'm just gonna cancel out of this wizard, and then go down to load balancers, and let's have a look. So I have a load balancer, and it's in the provisioning state. So I just need to wait another minute or two for it to become active, and then we can configure access logs for the load balancer. My load balancer is ready now. It's active. Let's just check that it's working correctly. There we go, it is working. That's great. My load balancer is now ready, so I'm going to select the load balancer, and on the Actions menu, select Edit Load Balancer Attributes, scroll down to the bottom, and expand the access logs here. And then I'm going to click on Browse S3 and choose my S3 bucket, and then save changes. Okay, so we've now successfully modified the load balancer attributes. So information should now start being logged. I'll copy that DNS name again. And I just want to generate some load on my load balancer. And I might try and specify something that doesn't exist just to generate some errors, hopefully, in the logs. Okay, so we've generated some traffic to our load balancer. It might take a few minutes for that information to show up in S3, so don't expect it to be there instantly. But let's just refresh the page. We do have the AWS logs folder, and now if we drill down, what we can see is this ELB access log test file. That was just the load balancer checking it had permissions to write, and it did do that successfully, so all is looking good. So in a few minutes, we should have some information getting logged into this folder structure. In the meantime, let's head over to Athena. So we'll open up the Athena service. So Athena will allow us to run SQL queries against the Amazon S3 data. Now, if we click on Launch Query Editor, it's going to take us here. Now, one of the things you have to do before you start working with Athena is set the query result location, and it needs an S3 bucket. So what I'm going to do is just create another one, and I'm going to call this Athena Query Results and just create the bucket. If we come back now, I'm going to select Manage, Browse, and then I'll choose my Athena Query Results bucket. Okay, if you don't do that, it will generate some errors or it won't allow you to run queries in Athena. Once we've done that, we can come back to the editor here, and we're going to come back to this document And here we have the option to create a table in Athena. So we're going to run an SQL query here that creates an external table if it doesn't exist called ALB_logs. And then all this information corresponds to the information that's going to be in the log files. So what we need to do is come all the way down to the bottom here, and you'll notice that we have a location. So we're going to need to make some updates to this location. Okay, so we need our bucket name, and then we need our account number. So let's come back up. I'm going to go to find my buckets. Here's my access logs bucket. I'll copy that. Let's paste that in here. / AWS logs is correct. Then I need my account ID or account number, which is up here. So I'm going to copy that, put that here, and hopefully that should be the correct path. Let's just go back and check that that's the case. So if I go into my bucket here, we'll just refresh. Yeah, elastic load balancing. So that does look correct. Now we have some information. We can actually drill all the way down here and you'll find a file. Let's download this file and we'll have a look at it so I can show you what is in the file. So I've opened the file with Visual Studio Code and we can see some information in here. So we've got HTTP requests, just a few of them. We can see some information about the load balancer, things like source and destination IP addresses, the requests that were being made. We can see the browsers that were being used. So there's quite a bit of information about the requests made to the load balancer. Right, so let's go ahead and copy all of this SQL query right from line 22 on my screen here down to 62 with the location properly filled out. And we'll come back to the query editor in Athena, paste this in, and then we're going to click on run. Okay, and that completed successfully, and we now have a table called ALB logs on the left-hand side, and you can see the information that's going to be picked up from the log files. Now we can run some queries. So this one here will view the first 100 access log entries in chronological order. So I'll copy that query. Let's come back. I'm going to open a new query window, put this in here, and then run. And of course, this SQL query is looking into the ALB logs table. And here we've got some results in order. The next one will list the clients in descending order by the number of times that each client visited a specified URL. So I'll copy this SQL query. Let's open a new query editor, paste this in, click on run. And now we have a couple of different entries here for the various requests that have been coming in. Of course, they only came from one IP address in this case. The last one shows the URLs visited by Chrome browser users. That'll be interesting because I wasn't using Chrome, so there may or may not be something in here. Okay, so we don't have any results for that one. I'm using Safari. If you're using Chrome, then of course that will show some results. Alternatively, and I haven't tested if this works, so I'm not sure if I can just change it to Safari, but let's have a look. Yes, I can. So now I can see that because I connected from Safari, I do have some entries. So what we've done here is demonstrated that we can log information about the request hitting our load balancer, and then if we want to run SQL queries, we can do so in a serverless fashion by leveraging Amazon Athena. Now, I have finished with this particular exercise, so I'm going to come back, delete my ALB access logs CloudFormation stack, and then afterwards you can clean up your S3 bucket, and you can delete the table once you've finished with it back here in Amazon Athena as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete my table, confirm by putting in the name of the table, and we're all cleaned up.